Hello, my beautiful narc-free family. So I had a subscriber request that I do a video on the hobosexual. So that's what I'm going to do. And before I start doing my video, I'm going to recommend also that you check out Dr. Carmen Bryant's channel. And she has done a video on that topic also that I happened to watch recently. So let's get started. So some of you know that there are narcissists who have money, make really good money, and are in industries that make good money, and they do well. However, there is a flip side to that. There are narcissists who basically couch surf, and you're probably wondering how they get away with this. Well, this is what it looks like, because I have clients who have talked to me about this, and I have seen this situation before, and I myself have been a victim to it for a temporary period of time. So what happens is they come to you with a story, some victim story. They are going through a divorce, or they have something going on, all right? And you know, their job is not paying them, because maybe they're a lab tech or something at a laboratory, and the job is, the insurance is not paying the job, and so the job is not paying them. They're having to wait for their check, or so they say, all right? And so they're coming to you like they want to talk to you, and they're in the idealization phase, and they are spending all this time with you and FaceTiming you all in this, and they're weaving in this little stories, okay, here and there, to kind of get your sympathy and your empathy, all right? And so what happens is you start feeling bad for them and feeling like they need someone to look after them, and because they have mirrored you and made you so happy, you can't see that something is wrong with the holes in their story, okay? Because you've become under the narcissist spell, and that's why you can't see. So don't beat yourself up. When you have been ensnared by a narcissist, it's all orchestrated. There's nothing to beat yourself up about. You couldn't have known until you know. Once you are awake to this type of thing, once you see it, you will never, ever be able to unsee it, and you will be looking for red flags once you are fully awake, all right? So one of my clients had this happen, and what it was, she met a guy. He lied about his age. He lied about his you know, the number of children he had, about his name, all right? And what happened was, one day he was driving her car, and he got pulled up, and he got a ticket, and they were together, and the officer printed the ticket out right there on the spot. And when she started looking at the ticket, obviously his information was on there with his name. And what he had done is, maybe let's say his last name was Brown. He said his last name was Browning. And his first name, he had just used a nickname. So that wasn't his first name at all. Let's just say that his first name was Robert. He was going by Tom Browning, or I think those names can coincide. So let's not say his name was Robert, and he was going by Derek, okay? Something totally different. It wasn't anything close. He was just whatever name he wanted, all right? So now she finds these things out. So now with the real name, she's able to look him up and find out some things about him. But meanwhile, while she's doing all her little private investigative work, this guy is living with her, okay? And she's reached out to me for some help, and I'm kind of picking apart what she's saying. I said, you know, she's saying to me, she's like, well, he stays with me during the week. He's here all during the week and everything is fine. But on the weekends, when I try to text him and when I try to call him, I don't get a response back and I can't reach him. And she's telling me how much money he's spending on her. So just because someone is spending money on you, as you're about to find out, doesn't mean it's their money that they're spending on you. So what this guy was doing was, he basically had another supply that was married. This supply had a wealthy husband, and she herself did well financially. Okay, they both had really good careers. So what she was what he was doing was he had her debit card, and she was renting a vehicle for him. And because she was married, she was only seeing him on the weekend at a second home that her husband and her owned. All right. So this rental car that he was driving could only go to three different states: the state he was in then, the state that his children were in, and the state where the other supply, where her house was. Okay. He wasn't supposed to go anywhere else. So what he basically was doing was using two people. He had one supply that was giving him a place to live. Therefore, he is a hobo, because he's just going from place to place laying his head. And then he had another supply that was taking care of him financially. So he was using that debit card, buying this person, this client of mine, very expensive gifts. We'd added up that he had spent in a week, in 1 week, he had spent $1,200 on her. So I was like, let's do the numbers here. I think he's telling her he's making $100,000. I'm like, well, I don't know anyone that can work only on the weekends and make $100,000. He had told her that he was doing something with some cell phone towers, okay? And even if this were true and he was, in fact, doing this, you should still be able to reach him, okay? Which you are not. So some things about this are not making any sense. So what he's doing is using his sexuality, and narcissists who do that are known as somatic narcissists. They use their sexuality to reel victims in, okay? And then once they've reeled them in and they're getting what they want from them, they start also using them for other things besides just sex, like a place to stay. So really, in all honesty, this guy was homeless, okay? But he knows that if he goes and tells a woman that, hey, I don't have a place to live, that's probably not going to get him what he wants. So what does he do? He doesn't tell either one of them he doesn't have a place to live. He just uses them for whatever it is he needs in that moment, okay? So when you meet someone and they start coming to you with that victim story, especially the one about their horrible ex or their horrible ex-wife, you guys need to be very careful when you're listening to those stories, because those stories pull at your heartstrings, especially when children are involved, and you start helping people who may not actually need your help. They actually have positioned themselves in this way. So this particular gentleman had some benefits, some military benefits that he was receiving, and that was his only income. So with that income, he probably could have afforded a place, but it wouldn't have been the type of place that he wanted. So for those of you who don't know, narcissists are very greedy and they're predators. And so there's never enough. The more that they get, the more that they want. So he didn't want to drive like a regular car or live a regular life or live within his means. So by him basically taking from other people, he was able to secure a residence for free and money for free. Okay, basically he was taking care of someone's sexual needs, and they were giving him money and giving him a rental car and allowing him access to everything that they had. And then he was using someone else for his place of residence and gifting that person with someone else's finances so that he could keep on playing this game. Well, you know that didn't end up very well, because the client reached out to the supply that was financing him and let her know what was going on. And obviously she's going to want her rental vehicle back, and she wants her debit card back and all of her things back. And so he's only left now with the person that he can stay with. And then by this time, she doesn't want the person that she has, because she thought she had somebody who made a good income and who was being really good to her. And in actuality, this wasn't ever his money. So he was being good to her with someone else's money, not money he made. All right. So when you meet these people that we call hobosexuals, these are people who are using their sex to their advantage. I did a video on sex with the narcissist. I'm going to post it up top here. So y'all look at that video, because that helps you to better understand how they use sex as a weapon. And when you're in that fog, you don't really necessarily see what is happening, because that love bombing phase has you in entranced, and it's very intense. And before you know it, you've lost your time, your resources, your energy, your sanity, and everything else. So when you meet somebody and they come to you with a story, it is not your job to fix people's problems. It's okay to tell people, I realize that you're going through a divorce, and that, you know, maybe something is going on with you that has caused you to be in this situation, and it's bad. And I hope that everything gets well for you. However, at this time in my life, I don't feel like it's any of my business to involve myself too intently in your life, because you really don't know this person when you first meet them. And some of us are so gullible, and we have big hearts, and we start getting involved in stuff. It is none of your business to get involved with one of these people, only to find out that they actually use you. They use you for all intents and purposes to get what they needed for themselves. And their intent as a narcissist was never, ever, ever to build you up or to ever be married to you. Although some of them may marry you temporarily, a narcissist can't be functional, okay? They can't be in a good functioning non-toxic relationship. A toxic narcissist cannot provide you with an untoxic relationship, because they don't possess the ability to do so. So the thing you thought that you were getting, that package that they came wrapped up in, or that you thought they were wrapped up in, is nothing more than an illusion. When you find out who people really are and they show you who they are, please believe them and deny them access to you and exit that toxic relationship where people lie to you like that, and they're really just sleeping on your sofa and bringing their drama to your home and bringing a bag of clothes with them when they come. And, you know, they're telling you that their ex put them out. There's a reason why their ex put them out. You're going to put them out too. I may have to do a part two on this topic, because so many of y'all are getting caught up in this and you are ending up very hurt. I may need to do a part two on this. Thank y'all for joining me here for this part of it. And if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and do so now. I look forward to meeting up with you again soon. Bye-bye, my beautiful narc-free family. Mwah, 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 mwah. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye-bye.